I think it's different that we're trying to build skill sets within a school, but that we're bringing them together across the schools so that they can learn how to communicate with different kinds of people. The programmer, I'm looking forward to, you know, the programmer who's never talked to an artist has never talked to a programmer, talking to each other about how to build something. The cool thing about these students is that they don't know boundaries. They really don't know, they think completely outside the box. They haven't been in industry so long that they think a certain way. So their creativity is off the chart. So I'm asking them to come up with creative games. I'm not dictating to them, hey, you're gonna make this kind of game. They're gonna come together in teams and say, we wanna make this kind of game. And if it fits within the criteria that we want, then hey, go off and make it.
Hi, my name is Stephen Cook. I'm the team lead for Team Milk, and we're working on a 2D side-scroller game about a carton of milk who's trying to rescue his best friend, who is a cookie called Ladyship, from different foods in the food pyramid. Right now, there are rotten eggs that are the enemies.
I was trying to find something that would be visually interesting to draw, and I was also watching the Food Network while I was designing this, so I may or may not have been extremely hungry when planning out this game, but really a lot of the game has evolved over time and with all of our ideas. Like, it was really just I made up some characters, but really what you see here is the work of all of us, and it's been really cool to see it evolve over time in this process.
What I think is important is that students learn through doing, by doing projects. And so we quickly meet together in the beginning of a class, and then we disperse in this place, the FAC lobby, so that each team works together, and then we review what they're doing and help them decide on what's the next step in the project and how it says they're in. And any technical problems that they have, we try to help them. But really, it's about the students trying to solve the problems themselves.
It's kind of like networking, but like in school, it's nice to work with other people who aren't in art, and they like teach you things. Like, I know a little bit coding now because of Leo and Ian, who are like my programmers in my group.
Our game is Precursor, and it's a turn-based game. So you have your player and your robot, and you take so many turns. You have action points. So you make a move, you can only, then it reduces your points by 4. So then you decide whether you want to attack an enemy, you want to gather parts to build yourself up, so you'll have better defense, and then once your turn is over, the enemies get to attack, and then it keeps going from there until either they kill you or you kill them.
I mean, obviously the objective is to make a fun game, but that's not how you start out. You start out by creating an experience for the player that puts them get some kind of feeling out of it, and then they evaluate that feeling as being fun. How do you teach that? Well, how do you teach something that's irrational? This is one of the challenges, and actually I think this is a great learning experience for kids. Oftentimes in education, we teach the rational because that's easy. But oftentimes in the real world, the irrational rules, because when you go out in the real world, people are not just in, you know, little stovepipes, but actually have to communicate with everyone. So I think that is a unique within UT. My name is Paul Toprac. I am the Associate Director of Game Development at the University of Texas at Austin, as well as Senior Lecturer. I am helping build a world-class game development program at UT.